Hi, this is Krista at Do Yoga With Me. In this class, we will play with putting our feet behind our heads. You don't need to be able to put your foot behind your head in order to do the class. It's just fun to work towards. So let's go try, have fun. Come to standing, please, at the front of your mat. Bring your hands to your heart center. Close your eyes and take three breaths. Chair pose, bend your knees, lift your arms towards the sky, please. Inhale. Forward fold, bow towards the earth as you exhale. Halfway lift, heart forward, inhale. Bend your knees, plant your palms on the earth. Step your right foot back, plank pose, upper push-up, exhale. Take an inhale here, roll your shoulders back. Option to lower your knees if you like, as you exhale. Either way, suck your belly in, heart forward, inhale. Bend your elbows, exhale, just halfway down. Keep your shoulders higher than your elbows. Inhale to press up. Again, exhale, bend just halfway down. Knees can be up or down as you do this. Inhale to lift up. Exhale, halfway lower. You could ignore me anytime. I'm always okay with that. Inhale to press up. This time halfway or all the way down as you exhale. Back bend, untuck your toes. Lift your heart, cobra or up dog, inhale. Downward facing dog as you exhale. Take a deep breath in and a full breath out. Lift your right leg towards the sky, please, inhale. Right foot forward and through, exhale, warrior two. Back heel pivots plants, windmill your arms up, out to the left, please, as you breathe in. Exhale, settle your shoulders and your hips. Bend your front right knee more forward and to the right. Okay. Lift your heart as you breathe in. Bring your front thigh a little more parallel to the earth as you exhale. Okay. Peaceful warrior, back hand down your back leg, front arm up and back as you breathe in. Press your hips more forward down as you exhale. Keep moving your right knee to the right. Okay, lift your heart up and back when you breathe in, and then reach as far back as you can as you exhale. Slide your back hand down your back leg as much as feels good in your body. Okay, stay here, suck your lower belly in, or maybe snake your back, left arm around towards your front right hip crease. Okay, press your arm into your back and towards your arm. Stay here, bend your top elbow, cradle the back of your head with your palm, press your head into your head. Okay, wherever you are, one more big breath in. And one more full breath out. Warrior two, inhale, lift up, open your arms please, and then straighten your front knee. Exhale, hips go back, front fingers forward and down, triangle pose. Either bottom hand to your shin or bring your fingertips towards the earth, either way is great. Press your bum forward underneath you, lift the left side of your heart up and back. Lift your gaze as high towards the sky as feels good for you. Maybe even look at your top fingers. If you like, give your top fingers a little sparkle, 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 sparkle. One more breath in. One more breath out. Back to warrior two, please. Inhale, lift up and open your arms. Okay. Heel toe your right foot a little closer to the right edge of your mat, please, as you exhale. Bend your front right elbow to 90 degrees, fingers point up, inhale. Eagle arms, back arm sweeps forward underneath your front arm, exhale, left elbow under right. Okay. Lift your palms tall, take a deep breath in. Bow forward and down, exhale, arms on the inside of your front thigh. So you can literally bring your right armpit towards your right inner knee. Okay. Bring your front knee forward over your front heel, and then bow your heart, your elbows towards the ground as much as you can. Okay. Squeeze your inner thighs, and move your whole bum more to the left. Two more breaths. A little more down with each exhale. Inhale, look forward, please. Bring your hands beneath your shoulders on the inside of your front foot. Exhale, back heel lifts off the ground. Breathe in. Lower your back knee down to the ground as you exhale. Lizard pose. Turn your front right toes a little bit out to the right, about 30 degrees. Lift your heart forward and up as you breathe in. Walk your hands forward and bow. Exhale, lower onto palms or possibly forearms. When your heart comes down, it's okay for your front right knee to move a little bit out to the right. Just make sure your toes are also pointing out to the right, so your kneecap and your toes point the same way. Once your heart's down as much as you can get it, press into your left hand or left forearm to move your weight more over into your right hand or right forearm, so your weight is even between your hands or elbows. From there, heart bows down, squeeze the inside of your right knee towards the outside of your right shoulder. Move your back knee back as much as you can. A few more breaths just like this. Allow the back of your neck to lengthen, your head to get heavy, so your neck can release completely. One more big breath in. One more full breath out. Lift your heart, please. As you inhale, walk your hands back in beneath your shoulders. Lift your back knee off the ground. As you exhale, turn your front toes a little more forward. Bring your weight forward onto your front foot as you breathe in. Yogic squat, front of your mat. Step your back foot forward. Toes out, heels in. Bend your knees wide out to the sides. Bring your hands to your heart center, please, if possible. If you tip backwards when you do this, no worries. Fingertips stay on the ground. Heels, if possible, on the ground, but if they need to lift up, no worries, you do that. Okay. Lift your heart towards your thumbs, close your eyes. I invite you to join me in three ohms here. Deep breath in. Eyes, please. Inhale. Bring your hands beneath your shoulders. Crow pose. Spread your fingers wide. Elbows and knees bend outwards. Come on your tippy toes so you can rest the insides of your knees on the backs of your upper arms. Lift your bum up. Tilt your head forward and down. Lift your bum up. Tilt your head forward and down. Keep bringing your weight forward and down onto your hands until maybe your feet can start to lift off the earth. Okay. Don't worry about if your feet don't lift up off the ground today. There's always next time. Next, inhale, look forward, as far forward as you can, and then step, hop, dance your feet back, exhale, chaturanga, lower halfway, all the way down. And when you inhale, back bend, off for your heart up. Downward facing dog as you exhale. Deep breath in. And cleansing exhale through the mouth. One more like that, inhale. Let it all go. Lift your right leg towards the sky, please. Inhale. Pigeon, right knee forward behind your right hand as you exhale. Back left knee lowers, walks back, please. Inhale, lift your heart and walk your fingertips a little wider out to the sides, more in line with your hips. As you exhale, heart bows down to the right, circling down over to the left as you breathe in. And then again down to the right as you exhale. Over, up to the left, inhale. And exhale down. Inhale to lift up, and then switch direction, please, down to the left as you exhale. Inhale up to the right. Down to the left, exhale. One more time, inhale, lift. And this time, walk your hands forward and bow towards the earth. Exhale, sleeping pigeon. Lower onto your forearms, your head relaxes down. Flex your front right toes towards the ground, please. And squeeze the inside of your back left inner thigh inwards towards the midline of your mat. So move your right hip up, left hip down. And then allow your heart to bow, melt, get heavy. Three more breaths together. Deep inhale. Exhale. Inhale two. Exhale. Inhale three. And exhale. Inhale, lift your heart, please. Bring your hands beneath your shoulders. Downward facing dog as you exhale. Inhale, lift your heels, look forward at your hands. Step, hop, dance your feet forward, front of your mat, exhale. Halfway lift, big breath in, heart forward. Exhale, fold, melt. All the way up, arms lift, please, as you breathe in. Hands to heart, center, exhale. Chair pose, Utkatasana, bend your knees, arms lift, inhale.
Uttanasana, forward fold, bow, exhale.
Halfway lift, heart forward, inhale.
Bend your knees, plant your palms on the earth, left foot back, right foot back, plank pose, upper push-up, exhale. Okay. Inhale here, shoulders back. Option to lower your knees down for half plank as you exhale for a little more support. Okay. Either way, roll your shoulders back, belly hugs in, inhale, and then bend just halfway down as you exhale. Inhale to lift up. Exhale, elbows bend back, shoulders stay back. Inhale to lift. Exhale, lower, keep it going. Check your smile, yeah. Hey, check your breath. I love yoga, I love yoga, I love yoga. Hey, one more time, exhale, lower. Inhale, lift. This time, lower halfway or all the way down. Back bend of your choice, cobra or up dog, inhale. Downward facing dog as you exhale. Lift your left leg towards the sky, please. Inhale. Left foot forward and through. Exhale, warrior two. Back heel pivots plants. Windmill your arms up, out to the right as you breathe in. And settle your shoulders, your hips as you exhale. Lift your heart up out of your hips, shoulders back and down. Really draw that left knee to the left a lot. Peaceful warrior, back hand down your back leg, front arm up and back, breathe in. Move your hips forward, down as you exhale, left knee to the left. Okay. Lift your left armpit up and then slide your right hand down your right leg to move your left side body up and back more. So rather than a back bend, imagine this as a side stretch, hips squared straight out to the long edge of your mat as much as possible. Okay. Open your beautiful throat up and back, stay here, or back right hand reaches around behind for your front left hip crease. Press your arm into your back to your arm. Bend your top left elbow, cradle the back of your head with your hand, and press your head in towards your hand. Feels so good. Okay. One more breath wherever you are. Open up and back in your heart. Warrior two, inhale, lift up, open your arms and straighten your front knee. Exhale, triangle pose, hips back, front fingers forward and down to your front shin or towards the earth. Press your bum forward underneath of you to the right. Lift the right side of your heart up and back. From there, draw your bottom left sit bone up and back in space a little bit more. Allow your top right hip to come slightly down and forward so your hips come more in a diagonal. Notice how that lengthens your bottom left side body. And then from there, open your heart up and back even more. Squeeze your inner thighs. If possible, look up at your top fingers. Give them a little sparkle, 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 sparkle. Bend your front knee forward, please. Warrior two, inhale. And settle for the exhale. Bend your front left elbow, please. Fingers point up, elbow 90 degrees, inhale. Back arm down, forward, exhale. Eagle arms, right arm under left. Heel toe your front left foot a little bit more to the left, please, closer to the left edge of your mat. Okay. Inhale, lift your elbows tall, hug your belly in. As you exhale, bow forward and down, elbows on the inside of your front thigh. So you can literally move your left armpit towards your left inner knee, and then move your elbows down and forward as your heart bows towards the earth. Squeeze your inner thighs towards each other. Lift your back right knee high, and lift the inner arch of your back right foot higher, glue the outside edge of the right foot down. This supports this forward moving energy. One more breath, please. Bow as far down as you can, your elbows, your heart. Okay. Inhale to look forward. Bring your hands beneath your shoulders. Exhale, lift your back heel up, breathe in. Lower your back knee down as you exhale. Lizard pose, turn your front left toes out about 30 degrees. And lengthen your heart forward as you breathe in. And you walk your hands forward and bow. Exhale, lower your palms, maybe your forearms towards the earth. Once you're down in your heart as much as you like, press into your right elbow or hand, move your weight more towards your left arm. Press your left big toe mound down and squeeze the inside of your left knee towards the outside of your left shoulder. Heart bows down, back of the neck lengthens, please, head gets heavy, loose, relaxed. One more big breath in, full breath out. Inhale, lift your heart, please. Walk your hands back in underneath your shoulders, close to your front foot. Okay, lift your back knee off the ground, please. Exhale, turn your front toes forward.
Shift your weight towards your front foot as you breathe in. Lift your heart. Step your back foot forward to the outside of your hands. Yogic squat, front of your mat. Exhale, toes out, heels in. And bring your hands to your heart center again, if possible. Press your knees wider. Lift your heart up out of your hips. Good. Take a moment here. Reconnect your smile. Lovely. Bring your hands beneath your shoulders, please. Crow pose number two. Okay. Spread your elbows a little wider, knees a little wider. So rather than your kneecaps resting on your triceps, instead bring your inner knees in the backs of your arms. Okay. Lift your bum high, head forward and down, forward and down. Okay. Once you've found where you want to be, three ohms, inhale. Forward, inhale, and chaturanga as you exhale, step or hop back. Lowering down through your vinyasa, inhale, heart lifts, cobra or up dog. And downward loving dog as you exhale. And please lift your left leg towards the sky, inhale. Pigeon, left knee forward, behind left hand, exhale. Back right knee lowers and walks back. Okay, lift your heart a little taller, please. Inhale. Tense your fingers wider back, more in line with your hips. Inhale to offer your heart towards the sky. Roll your head, your torso down to the left. Exhale, circling down to the left, up to the right. Inhale, head is loose, heart leads the movement. Exhale, down to the left. Inhale, up to the right. Exhale down. One more time, lift up, inhale. And switch direction down to the right, exhale. Inhale to roll up. Exhale down. One more time, inhale. And hands walk forward, bow all the way forward and down. Lower to your forearms as you exhale. Hey, once you've arrived, check that your front left toes are pressing down. Your back right inner thigh is squeezing inwards, back heel straight up towards the sky. Okay. Hugging inner thighs, left hip up, right hip down. And then again, allow your heart to melt, your head to get heavy. Support the head if that's more comfortable for you with palms or fists. And three more breaths together, deep inhale. Full exhale. Inhale two. Exhale. Inhale three. And exhale. Inhale, lift your heart, please. Walk your hands in beneath your shoulders. Downward facing dog, exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Lift your heels, look forward, inhale. Step or hop your feet to the front of your mat, exhale. Halfway lift, big breath in. Exhale, fold, melt, bow. All the way up, arms lift, please, as you breathe in. Hands to heart center, exhale. Take a little step back on your mat, please. And chair pose, bend your knees, arms lift up as you inhale. Bring your hands to your heart center, a little lower as you exhale. Lift your right heel off the ground as you breathe in. And draw your right knee up into your heart. As you exhale, straighten your standing leg. Bring the outside of your right ankle, please, on top of your left thigh for standing figure four. Draw your right knee back, right hip forward as your heart lifts. Okay, stay just like this. Enjoy the balancing pose. Or begin to move your heart forward and down. Okay, folding down in your figure four. As the heart moves down and forward, lift your bum up and back. And stay here. Maybe elbows come to rest in the inner right shin. Maybe hands to bottom shin, or fingertips towards the earth, bow down. Keep flexing your right foot a lot, please. Whatever you're doing, keep that right knee safe. If your hands easily touch the ground, you walk your hands a little bit more forward until your palms can touch the earth, hands shoulder distance. Bend your elbows in towards your heart, lift on the tippy toes of your standing foot, and then place your right shin along the backs of your triceps, your upper arms. Hook the toes of your right foot strong around the back of your left arm. From there, lift your bum up, head comes down. Lift your bum up, head comes down. Okay. Maybe left foot lifts off the earth, maybe left leg extends back. Okay. Take one more breath, look forward as you breathe in. And chaturanga, step hop, dance your feet back, lower down when you exhale. Okay. Inhale, offer your heart up, back bend. Downward facing dog as you exhale. Lift your right leg towards the sky, please. Inhale. Right foot forward and through. As you exhale, warrior two, back heel pivots plants. Windmill your arms up out to the left as you breathe in. Okay. As you exhale, big exhale through the mouth, let it all go. And close your eyes if possible and take three breaths here. Feel the alignment in your body. Inhale, one. Exhale. Inhale, two. Exhale. Inhale, three. And exhale. Okay. Open your eyes, please. Inhale. Windmill your hands down to the inside of your front foot as you exhale. Heel toe your right foot a little more to the right again. Hands beneath shoulders, lower your back knee down to the ground. This time I'd love you to flex your front right toes up off the ground so everything lifts but the heel, and then turn the toes and the knee out to the right. Come to rest on the outside pinky toe side of your right foot. From there, square your hips forward, left hip back, right hip forward. Lift your heart as you breathe in. And walk your hands forward and bow as you exhale. Again, come onto forearms if that's appropriate for you. Allow your heart to melt towards the ground. So this time the knee and the toes can externally rotate out to the right as much as your hips allow. If it doesn't feel good to rest on the outside edge of your right foot, then don't do it. Just bring the sole of the foot on the ground. Okay, one more breath wherever you are. Inhale, lift your heart forward, please. Bring your hands beneath your shoulders. Okay. Bring the sole of your right foot back down on the ground, please. And then bring your right hand behind your right heel. Really nuzzle your right shoulder underneath of your right knee and press your right elbow forward out to the right to help draw the knee forward. Okay, make sure that your heel's forward of your knee on the mat. If the foot's back here, this is really difficult to do. So walk the foot as far forward as you need until the heel's forward of the knee. From there, bow the crown of your head towards your front heel. Try to reach your head towards your foot. Keep moving your right knee forward with your right arm. Hips come down as your heart melts. If it becomes appropriate for you, then put your foot behind your head. There's always next week. One more inhale. And one more exhale. Inhale, lift your heart, please. Walk your hands back forward. Okay. Three-legged dog, plant your palms, lift your back knee, and swing your front right leg up and back towards the sky behind you. Bend your top knee and stack your right hip over your left. Press into your hands, move your right armpit down towards your back foot, and then press your bottom left heel down. Lift your knee a little bit higher, open your beautiful hips. Okay, stay here, or you can flip your dog, come on the tippy toes of your standing foot, and then heel rotates away from you until the right foot can release to the ground behind you. Okay, from there, press into the outside edge of your left foot, lift your heart, reach your right arm forward. One more breath in, one more breath out. Back to three-legged dog, please lift your right leg towards the sky as you breathe in. Then right foot forward again to the outside of your right hand as you exhale. Hey, lower your back knee down to the ground. Again, bring your right hand back behind your right heel. Walk the right foot a little bit more forward. Heart down, please, elbow wide out to the right. Walk your left hand back in line with your right hand and then lift your back knee up off the ground. Okay. Lift your bum high, look forward, and then begin to bounce your hips. And then see if you can give a little hop with your back foot. Hop. Yeah. And then try again. This time, hop your foot a little bit forward. And then hop the foot back again. Okay. This time, hop the back foot as far forward in line with your front foot as you can. And then hop it back again. This time, we're going to hop the foot all the way forward and come onto your bum. Okay. So hop the back foot forward. Knee can come wide out to the left. And then onto your bum. Maybe that right leg ends up on your right arm. Okay, if not, you just meet us there, okay, holding your right calf with your right hand. Beautiful. You can draw the left knee a little wider out to the side, or you can bring your left leg forward, whatever's most comfortable for you. Okay. Either way, hold underneath the right calf with your palms, or possibly your elbows. Hands can come to a prayer. Or next option, interlacing fingers around the calf. So right knee and right elbow,
and sole right foot into left elbow. From there, draw that right hip forward on the earth, please, and then lift your heart tall, hug your calf in towards your heart. Okay, if you'd like, you can rock your baby a few times here. Okay, so forward and back with your leg. If you're feeling extra loving towards your baby, you can give it some kisses. Okay, keep lifting your heart tall. Okay. From here, please hold underneath of your right calf with your right hand and hold the sole of your right foot with your left hand. Option one, figure four, seated, outside of right ankle on top of left thigh. Option two, generous Shirshasana, sole the right foot to the inner left thigh. Either way, lift your arms tall, please. Inhale. And bow forward and down as you exhale towards your front leg, hands on front shin, on the foot, on the earth, whatever feels good. Roll your shoulders back, please. Hug your belly and inhale. And bow forward and down towards your front leg as you exhale. Flex your right foot strongly. Press your right knee down to the right. If your right foot's on top of your left thigh, you might feel pressure of the foot on the leg. Completely fine, yeah, to feel pressure there, just not pain in your knee or your ankle. Okay? Easiest place to place the foot is so that the foot is resting on the thigh muscle between the ankle and the sole of the foot. Okay? You do what's best for you. Last two breaths wherever you are, please. Next inhale, lift your heart, your arms towards the sky, big breath in. And then bring your fingertips onto the earth behind you as you exhale. You lean back on your hands, bend your front left knee and place the sole of your foot on the ground. Okay? If you haven't already, place the outside of your right ankle on top of your left thigh, please. Okay. Lean back on your hands so much that maybe you can lift your front foot off the ground. Oh, suddenly that right foot gets so heavy. Okay, hug your belly and lift your heart. If you have any lower back issues, keep your hands on the ground just like this. If possible, bring your arms forward in front of you, palms facing. Okay. If it's a little too intense today in your hips, your knee, your ankle, no worries. Knees together instead, please, for a Navasana boat pose. Otherwise, figure four boat pose. Take an inhale to draw your knee or knees closer and towards your heart. And then exhale, extend your leg or legs more forward. Inhale, draw your knees or knees more in. Exhale, legs forward. One more time, inhale, draw in. Exhale, leg forward. And pause here, please. Do three little mini lifts with your front foot. One, two, three. Good. Inhale, draw your knee in. Exhale, leg forward. One more time. Three little mini lifts. One, two, three. Inhale, draw your knees or knees in. Release the sole of your left foot back into the ground. Exhale. Hold underneath of your right calf one more time. Either palms or crooks of the elbows. Okay. Flex your right foot a lot, please. And then let's lift that left leg off the ground one more time. Inhale. Come all the way onto your back as you exhale, please. Weesh. Extend your left leg forward, hover it off the earth, okay? And really hug your right leg in. One more breath, just like this. Please bend your front left knee and place the sole of the foot on the ground near your hips, okay? Again, hold the sole of your right foot with your left hand and hold underneath the right ankle or leg with your right hand. The more you press into your front left foot to lift your hips off the ground, the easier it is to start to draw that top leg in towards your heart. Okay. So press into your front foot, lift your hips slightly, and then see if you can touch your big toe to your nose. And then see if you can comb your hair with your foot. Okay. That worked out okay. Touch the heel of your foot to the top of your head. Press into your front foot a lot. Maybe bring your foot behind your head. Okay. Smile wherever you are. A couple more breaths to find your fullest expression. And then release, please. Draw both knees in towards your heart. Squeeze your knees in and give yourself a big lip flutter. Cross your ankles, please. Begin to rock and roll up and down. Massage your beautiful back. Get enough momentum to roll all the way forward. Step or hop your feet back. Vinyasa, Chaturanga, or Downward Facing Dog. Medium Down Dog on your next exhale. Plank pose, heart forward, please. Inhale. And all the way down to your belly as you exhale. Your arms at your sides, please. Turn your palms inwards. Interlace your fingers behind your back. As you inhale, lift everything off the ground but your hips. Press your hands, your feet more back as you exhale. Inhale to lift taller. Exhale, go more back.
Last time, lift as tall as you can. Big breath in. And all the way down. Exhale. And hands beneath shoulders, child's pose. Lift up onto your hands, your knees as you inhale. And sit bones back towards your heels as you exhale. Take a few breaths here. Let it all go. Maybe a couple sighs if that feels good for you. Downward facing dog, please. Inhale, lift your heels, look forward at your hands. Step or hop your feet to your hands, please. Exhale. Halfway lift, big breath in. Inhale. Forward full bow, exhale. All the way up, arms lift as you breathe in. Hands to heart center, exhale. And take a little step back on your mat, please. Big toes touch. Chair pose, bend your knees, arms lift, inhale. Bring your hands to your heart center as you exhale. Lift your left heel off the ground, please, as you breathe in. And come to stand, draw your left knee in towards your heart, exhale. Figure four, bring the outside of your left ankle, please, on top of your right thigh as you breathe in. Heart lifts over hips. Stay here or begin to bend into your standing leg as you exhale. Draw your left knee back, left hip forward, wherever you are. See if you can begin to bow more and more forward and down, maybe elbows come to rest on the inside of your left calf. Maybe hands come to your bottom right shin by lifting your bum a little taller. Maybe fingertips all the way down towards the earth, straightening your standing leg more and bowing towards the earth. Take your shoulders back away from yours, hug your lower belly in. Wherever you are, please flex your left foot a lot. If your hands are on the ground, you want to go a little deeper. Ekapada Galavasana, walk your hands forward so your palms can plant on the earth. Bend your elbows in towards your body. Come on the tippy toes of your standing foot and place your left shin along the backs of your upper arms as high as you can. Hook the toes of your left foot around the back of your right arm. Lift your bum up, tilt your head forward and down. Bum up, head down, bum up, head down. Maybe your right foot lifts. Maybe your right leg starts to move back. Good, one more breath. Chaturanga, step, hop, dance your feet back, lower halfway or all the way down. Lift your heart up, inhale, offer it towards the sky. Downward facing dog as you exhale. Lift your left leg towards the sky, please, as you inhale. Left foot forward and through. Exhale, warrior two. Back heel pivots, plants. Windmill your arms up, out to the right, please, as you breathe in. Exhale, press your left knee forward to the left. Allow your hips to settle. You lift your heart tall. I invite you to close your eyes, please, and take three breaths. Just feel. Opening your eyes, deep breath in. Remember now your hands down to the inside of your front foot, please, as you exhale. You lift your back heel up. Heel toe your left foot a little closer to the left edge of your mat and lower your back knee down, please. Flex your front left toes up and then pivot the toes and knee out to the left. Come to rest on the outside of the pinky toe side of your foot. Okay. Inhale to extend your heart forward. Walk your hands forward and bow palms or forearms towards the earth. If it doesn't feel good to rest the outside pinky toe side of the foot, please don't worry about it. Bring the sole of the foot on the ground instead. Allow your heart to melt. Just one more breath here, please. Lift your heart up, please. Walk your hands back in beneath your shoulders. Check that your front heel's farther forward on the mat than your knee. Bring your left hand back behind your left heel. Heart bows down, please. Elbows draw wide out to the sides and nuzzle your left shoulder beneath your left knee a lot. Press your left knee forward with your left arm and then reach the crown of your head towards your front heel. As you dip your head down to the left, keep moving your left knee forward with your arm. And if you want, you can put your foot behind your head. Sound effects help.
Release, please. Bring your hands back underneath your shoulders. Three-legged dog, back knee lifts. Front left leg swings up and back behind you. Okay. Bend your top knee, stack your left hip up over your right hip. Press your bottom right heel down and back. Move your left armpit towards your left heel. Lift your top knee high. Okay, stay there or flip your dog. Right heel lifts, rotates out around behind you. Left foot releases to the ground. Come to the outside edge of your right foot. Reach your left arm forward, up, and open your throat. One more breath. Back to three-legged dog if you're not already. Left arm, left leg lifts towards the sky. Inhale. And left foot again to the outside of your left hand as you exhale. Back knee lowers. Again, please, heart bows down. Left hand behind left heel, nuzzle your left shoulder underneath your left knee. Bring your right hand back in line with your left. Bend your elbows wide, lift your back knee, your bum high towards the sky. Okay, look forward and begin to bounce your booty. See if you can give a playful little hop in your back foot. Hop, choo. Okay. And see if you can hop the foot a little bit forward. Toes can turn out, heel in, and then back again. Foot all the way forward in line with your front foot. And back again. And this time we're going to hop the foot all the way forward and through. So right knee out to the right, left heel lifts. Woo! And you come to your bum. Maybe left leg still on top of your left arm, maybe not. Either way is great. We'll meet there holding your left calf with your left hand. And right knee can either be bent out to the side or you can straighten your right leg forward or feels better in your body. From there, holding either underneath the left calf with your palms, please, or slide the calf up to the crooks of your elbows. Hands can come to a prayer. Or maybe interlacing fingers around your left shin. Left knee and left elbow. Right sole foot and right elbow. Hey, I'd love you to take that moment to slide your left sit bone forward in space. Just give you a little bit more room to lift your heart up. If you want to rock your baby a little bit side to side here, opening those hips a little bit more, you're very welcome to. If you find a really juicy spot in your hips, you can just kind of just hold there and breathe for a minute. Okay, and again, any little sweetness for your baby you'd like. Okay. One more breath in, and one more breath out. Release the outside of your left foot either on top of your right thigh for figure four again, or bring the sole of your left foot to the inside of your right thigh for Janushirasana. Lift your arms and heart tall towards the sky. Inhale. And bow forward and down, please. As you exhale, hold either your front leg or foot. Roll your shoulders back, suck your belly in when you inhale, and melt your heart towards your front leg as you exhale. Gently flex your front foot, please. Press your left knee down and line up your belly button with your right leg. Suck your lower belly in, please. Inhale to lift your arms, your heart towards the sky. And then release your hands near your sides as you exhale. Bring the sole outside of your left foot on top of your right thigh if it's not already, please. Bring your hands behind you, lean into your hands, and bend your right knee. Bring the sole of the foot on the ground. Okay. Press into your tented fingers behind you, lift your heart up, and then see if you lift your front right foot off the ground. Oh, yeah, we get to the other side, core work. Okay. If it's a little too intense, no worries. Inner knees touch instead, feet down as much as you need. Keep your heart lifted. Okay. Okay. If possible, arms forward, if your lower back allows. Inhale, please draw your knee or knees closer and towards your heart. Heart lifts. Exhale, legs forward. Inhale, draw your knees in. Exhale, extend forward. Okay. Inhale, knees in. Exhale, legs forward. Pause here. Three little mini lifts. One, two, three. Inhale, knees in. Exhale, legs forward. Again, one more time. Three little mini lifts. One, two, three. Inhale, knees in. Good, and exhale, release the sole of the foot on the ground. Hold underneath that left calf one more time with your hands. Hey, hug the leg in, palms, or maybe crooks of elbows if you feel. Hey, either way, straighten your front leg forward, please. Take a deep inhale. And then hold your leg as you roll into your back. Whee! Extend your right leg forward. Hold your front calf in towards your heart. Keep flexing your left foot strongly, please. Bend your front right knee, please, and place the sole of the foot on the ground near your hips. Okay. Press into your foot to lift your hips a little bit off the ground. Notice how that gives you more space to draw your front leg in towards your heart more deeply. Okay. Hold the sole of your left foot with your right hand, and hold underneath of your left ankle with your left hand. Okay. From there, see if you can touch your big toe to your nose. Doot, doot. See if you can comb your hair with your foot. Okay. Press into your front foot so much. Lift your bum a little more. Bring your heel to touch your head. Maybe slide your foot behind your head. Okay. If it worked okay to bring one foot behind your head, bring the other foot behind your head. Cross at your ankles behind your head. Maybe hands to prayer. One more breath wherever you are playing. And then release your knees in towards your heart. Please give yourself a nice lip flutter. Rock and roll yourself up and down a few times. Get enough momentum. Cross your ankles, pull out your palms, vinyasa or downward facing dog. Plank pose, heart forward, please inhale. And come all the way down to your belly as you exhale. Bend your knees, please. Bring your heels towards your bum. Hold the outsides of your ankles, shins, or feet with your hands as far down towards your knees as you can. Flare your toes, flex your feet if appropriate. Draw your knees straight back behind you so your inner thighs engage. Suck your belly in, please. Inhale, lift everything off the ground but your hips. Exhale, move your feet more back and up. Inhale to lift taller. Exhale, go back. One more inhale, lift, 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 lift. And all the way down, exhale. Okay. Plank pose, inhale, press up. Downward facing dog as you exhale. Inhale, lift your heels, look forward, please. Step or hop forward onto your knees, please. Knees forward, almost all the way together. Separate your feet wide, tops of the feet on the ground, feet pointed. Knees either together or hip distance, no wider than hip distance, please. Use your hands on your calf muscles to draw the flesh of the calves outwards, away from each other, and then see if you can place your sit bones on the earth between your feet. If that's a little too intense for your knees, sitting on some Hyatt, a block or two or five will really help. Okay. Still too intense, you sit on your heels for Thunderbolt Vajrasana, no problem. Either way, lift your heart tall, tilt forward on the edges of your sit bones. You can stay just like that, or to recline a little bit more, bring your hands behind you on the earth. Press into your hands to lift your sit bones up, and then slide your bum forward on your mat. So you shorten the front of your belly, lengthen your lower back. That might give you more space to walk your hands in, come onto your forearms. Okay, if it doesn't work, no worries, stay upright. If your knees lift up, usually that's an indication you've gone too far. You want to be able to keep your knees pressed towards the earth. If that still worked out, you want to go deeper. Again, lift your bum up, slide your bum forward on the earth, and come back a little more. If you come all the way onto your back, release your arms up above your head, hold opposite elbows, press your knees down and forward. Whatever you're doing, allow your throat to open, your chin to lift up and back. Big breaths. If you're not all the way back, allow the front of your throat to open, your head to drop back, if that feels good for your neck. If it doesn't feel good in your neck, then keep your neck neutral. Last few breaths wherever you are. If you recline, gently make your way back up and come onto your forearms first. Then hands, allow your bum to lift up and slide back to give your lower back more space, more natural curvature. And then come forward onto your knees, lift your bum, hands forward.
Okay, release this by coming back into your downward facing dog and walk your dog out a little bit, bending one knee, pressing the opposite heel down, switching sides as fast or as slow as you like. Maybe give your hips a little bit of a wiggle, your head a little bit of a shake. Optional last vinyasa if you like, heart forward when you inhale. Lower halfway or all the way down, exhale. Back bend of your choice, inhale. Downward facing dog, exhale. Inhale, lift your heels, please look forward. Come to your bum, step or hop your feet forward and through. Come onto your back. Hug your knees towards your heart, please. Give yourself a nice little squeeze here. Open your arms wide out to the sides. Make a T with your upper body. Either knees can stay side by side or cross your right thigh over your left for eagle legs. Allow your bottom left toes to touch down for a moment. Press into your toes, lift your hips and shift them over to the right. Draw your knees back in towards your heart when you inhale, and then roll your knees all the way to the left. When you exhale, roll to the outside edge of your bottom left hip. Use your left hand to help draw the knees down or support the knees up. Back of your right shoulder heavy, please, chin rolls to the right. Inhale, please lift your knees back up to center. And release the cross if your legs are crossed. And then cross the other way, left leg over right. Shift your hips a little bit over to the left. Draw your knees up when you breathe in. Roll your knees all the way to the right. Exhale, roll to the outside edge of your right hip. Right hand can help draw the knees down or support the knees up as you feel. Press the back of your left shoulder down, please. And if possible, roll your chin towards your left shoulder. Knees back up, please. Inhale, releasing any crosses as you exhale. And bring your knees, put your feet a little wider, please, near the edges of your mat. Windshield wipe your knees side to side a few times. And next time your knees roll to the left, please stay there, knees to the left. Stay just like that. Or lift your front left heel and allow the outside of the left heel to rest on the top of your right knee. Use your left heel to help draw the knees down to the left a little bit more. Release the foot, please, if it's on your knee. Knees back up when you inhale. Flop your knees to the right as you exhale. Stay there or lift your right heel. Allow the outside edge of your right foot to rest on top of your left knee. Use the foot to help gently draw the left knee closer towards the ground. Release the right foot down, please, if it's not already. Draw your knees back up when you inhale. Draw your knees in towards your heart. Bring your hands on your knees and do any little rolls, rocks, wiggles, or squeezes that feel good in your body. Check in with yourself, see if there's anything else you need for your practice to feel complete. If there is, take the time to move into it.
Release for Shavasana. For Shavasana today, I invite you to come to Supta Baddha Konasana. Soles of the feet together, knees wide out to the sides. Arms gently splayed, palms upwards. If it's a little bit too intense for your inner thighs or your lower back, you're welcome to either bring your palms near your hips underneath your thighs to help support them up, maybe make fists or use blocks. Or just release to regular Shavasana at any time, allowing your legs to lengthen and splay. Once you've found where you want to be, if you'd like to join me in three big sides, releasing any remaining bits of tension, you're so welcome to. Taking a deep inhale through your nose. Inhaling. Last one. Releasing control over your breath, allowing it to shift to passive, automatic breath. And your face relaxes. Your fingers and toes relax. 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 And begin to deepen your breath. And wiggle your fingers, your toes, your hands, your feet. And extend your legs long if they're not already. Your arms up above your head. Give yourself a full body stretch. Yawn. Draw your knees in towards your heart. Roll over to one side. And press yourself up to any comfortable seated position. Bring your hands to your heart center. Lift your heart towards your thumbs. Draw your lower back in and up. Extend the crown of your head taller. Relax the corners of your mouth, subtly upwards. Bow your head towards your heart.
from my heart to yours. Namaste.